Now that the science update is finally here, what's next for KSP2? And is it going to be worth it? Let's find out! Hello everybody and welcome! 2023 ended strong for Kerbal Space Program 2 with the release of version 0.20, nicknamed For Science, because it finally introduced science experiments, missions and the tech tree to the game. Despite the many flaws, the game is still in early access after all. I personally had a lot of fun with this iteration of KSP2. Just over the past days I dropped into the mohole, landed 300 tons on Duna and finished the official storyline so far. More of that in an upcoming video. And many of you joined me for a livestream where I attempted a Joule 5 mission, where I visit all of the 5 moons of the gas giant Joule and return with as much science points as possible. That Tidal landing was quite something, am I right? That's going to continue soon, so subscribe and don't miss when I go live again or release the other video I mentioned. So, what's in store for Kerbal Space Program 2 this year? The game is far from finished, as we can clearly see when taking a look at the roadmap. The developers are already working on the next big update, which is going to be Colonies and Orbital Construction. This is of course going to pay into later updates like Interstellar and Resource Gathering, because the further you want to go, the bigger your spacecraft needs to be, because you're going to need a lot of propellant and a lot of life support if you attempted an interstellar journey in real life. Colonies will enable players to construct outposts almost anywhere. Instead of having to wait years for your interplanetary ship to reach the outer planets to discover new things there, just have a local colony build a ship and launch it right there on location. And orbital shipyards will be key if we want to construct those humongous interstellar ships we have been seeing in previous feature videos released by the developers. Because while the new vehicle assembly building in KSP2 is much more spacious than the one from the original, it does have a size limit to what you'll be able to build. Speaking of building, how are we going to be able to build those colonies? Are they going to be a single gigantic piece you need to drop onto a planet? Do they require multiple deliveries of material and crew to construct them? From an old PC Gamer article, we know that colonies will be able to produce new colonists through undisclosed methods when players trigger so-called boom events. But if these are still going to be part of the game is unknown right now. Creative Director Nate Simpson did reply to some questions on the official Intercept Games Discord server, but he was sparse on the details, as he tends to be, understandably. However, he did drop this little bit of information. Since KSP2 introduced axial tilt to celestial bodies, something that wasn't done in the original, it might happen that some colonies are electricity starved during half of the year if they're solar powered. From this we can infer that colonies will require energy, and one form of generating this energy is going to be solar. Other forms for sure will include nuclear and fusion energy. At least if these power generation modules from an old show and tell video are anything to go by. Other buildings that we know about are of course the VAB, these fuel factories, and then there's going to be parts to form some sort of pavement. Other than that, not much else is known about the additional modules we're going to be able to construct next to our colonies. While he did not drop much information about the upcoming colonies milestone, Nate did, however, talk a little more about the things coming after that, which is going to be Interstellar. We know that the team has been working on this in parallel to the other milestones, and he confirmed as much during his impromptu AMA on Discord. The roadmap so far only speaks of 2 solar systems, one of them called Deb-Deb, but Nate said that 3 systems are already planned, so there's definitely more to come. And from his statements, it appears that the developers have let their creativity run wild. All within the confines of the laws of physics, I would hope. We already know about some of these new celestial bodies. There's the twin planets Rask and Rusk, there's the eyeball planet Puff, there's Glumo, and then there's Gordama, which was featured heavily in one of the developers' previous videos. And what's more, it seems that the Deb-Deb system will not be in the same position in the night sky every night. I'm not really good at astronomy, so anyone more knowledgeable than me, please drop a comment and let everyone know what Nate could mean by that. But we're getting a bit ahead of ourselves, since Interstellar stuff is even further away than the Colonies update. So how far away are we really talking? I asked this exact question back when I had the chance to interview Nate Simpson right after he was coming off stage from announcing the science update. Take a listen.
Can we expect the same roughly 10-month time frame for the upcoming features?
I think it's safe to say that we would be pretty disappointed if the amount of time between the first science update and the Colonies update was the same as the distance between launch and for science. Mm-hmm. I do think we were working on a lot more foundational stuff over the course of the first 8 months of the project, and that a lot of that stuff is getting squared away. So it should, in my opinion, come faster.
So based on the information you currently have, right?
Based on the estimates that I've seen, based on the scope of work for the Colonies update, I believe we are looking at a significantly shorter turnaround time.
If you're interested in the rest of that interview, you can check it out right here or by following the link in the video description. But based on Nate's answer and the fact that version 0.20 came out roughly 10 months after the initial early access release, my guess would be either end of June or the start of September. I can't imagine that they're going to release anything as big as a new feature update during the summer holidays. But of course, as we say in my neck of the woods, the devil never sleeps. Even if Nate's assessment was right at the moment of the interview, some unforeseen things can always pop up and result in unexpected delays. Personally, I don't mind them taking their time to make sure it's another solid update to KSP2, just like For Science was. And of course, some fixes to some long-standing bugs would be nice. I personally would finally like to see reliable delta V calculations. As it is now, you can't really trust the readouts in the VAB or during flight, which is a shame because that info would be really valuable if it were correct. And while re-entry heating is a welcome addition to the game, as it is now, it requires a lot of tuning still. This attempt to land on Lathe ended in disaster multiple times because the plane would overheat at altitudes and speeds that were totally fine for a craft of this type in the original game. But I'm sure they're going to get it right at one point. Speaking of getting it right, those multiple missions I talked about in the beginning of the video, those were done all at the same time basically, so I really hope they will include an alarm clock feature soon. Juggling with multiple flights is a bit of a hassle right now. But since one of their developers, TriggerAU, the creator of the original Kerbal alarm clock mod for KSP1, I am confident that this will make it into the game soon. Speaking of game, I have this monstrosity ready to launch soon, so that's what I'm going to do now. If you want to see me do that, make sure you're subscribed. I'm trying to break into the 100,000 subscriber range this year, and I would really appreciate it if you could help me reach that goal. And there's a lot of other stuff I have planned that will be coming up. Exciting times ahead, that's for sure.
If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe to my channel for more and follow me on my social thingies. The links are in the description. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.